Good morning, everyone. Welcome to your English language live class. We have been doing the chapter transformation of sentences. We have done few of the things. That is, we have learned how to change a sentence which includes the adverb to, and how do we remove to, and what are the words which we use in place of to. Again, we have also done the transformation of sentences which require the interchange of degrees of comparison. After that, we did the transformation of sentences from affirmative to negative and from negative to affirmative. If you know one way, then you automatically know the other way around. Okay, so today we'll continue with the same chapter, that is the transformation of sentences. Okay, and we will continue with the transformation of sentences, that is from assertive to interrogative sentences and vice versa. That means, how do we change an assertive sentence, a declarative sentence, into an interrogative sentence, right? So this here lies the first rule. The rule says, if the sentence is in affirmative, okay? Affirmative means, if you remember, I told you yesterday that affirmative means a positive sentence which does not have any negative word in it, that is without a no, not, never. So that is an affirmative sentence. So if the sentence is an affirmative, okay, then what do we have to do? You have to change it into negative interrogative. Okay, just pay attention over here. When the question is affirmative, by question I mean the sentence which is given in the question. Okay, if it is an affirmative sentence, then what do? We make it into a negative interrogative. Okay, and if it is negative, then you have to change it into interrogative. That means you have to change it into affirmative interrogative, right? So let us look at the example and the things will get clearer. See, he was very gentle. Okay, this is the question. This is how the question will be given to you, that this is the statement. This is an assertive statement and you have to change it into interrogative form. Now, when you look at the sentence carefully, he was very gentle. This is an affirmative sentence. Okay, affirmative means this is a positive sentence. So when the sentence is positive, what was being told in the rule, that when the sentence is positive, when the sentence is affirmative, we change it into negative interrogative. Okay, that means while making it an interrogative sentence, we have to add a negative word to it, right? So how do we change an interrogative into assertive? We pick out the helping verb and place it in the beginning, right? And then we copy the rest of the sentence and end it with a question mark. So the answer would have been, was he very gentle? But in the transformation of sentences, the rule says that if the assertive sentence is an affirmative sentence, then we have to make it into negative affirmative. Okay, and how do we make it negative interrogative? By adding a not after the helping verb. This is also one way of writing, and this is another way of writing. So if you write any of them, you will be given marks for that. So wasn't he very gentle? This is the short form of writing, was not. So wasn't he very gentle? Okay, or you can write in the expanded form, was he not very gentle? So see, in the question, in the statement, there is no not. That means the sentence is affirmative, but when we are changing it into interrogative, we are using a negative word, not. Okay, so this is what the first rule was. This is what the first rule was all about. Now the second part of the first rule said that if the statement given to you, if the assertive sentence is a negative assertive sentence, okay, here it will not be affirmative, rather it will be assertive. Okay, assertive. So when the assertive sentence is kind of negative sentence, then we have to change, we have to make it a positive interrogative. Let us see, how do we do that? He is not a good person. This sentence is a negative sentence because of the use of word not. And how do we change an assertive sentence into interrogative sentence? We pick out the helping verb and place it in the beginning. And now since the word not is given in the sentence, we won't be using it in our answer. Okay, so is he a good person? We have changed it into interrogative also, and we have changed it into affirmative also. So two kinds of transformation you have to do. That is, if the previous sentence, if the sentence given to you to transform is an affirmative sentence, then you will transform it into interrogative negative. And if the sentence which is given to you to transform is a negative sentence, then you have to convert it into positive also, and then you have to change it into interrogative. Okay. See one more example without with some other helping verb. We shall play, shan't we play? So this is a short form of writing shall not. Right, you can also write shall we not play, like we did over here in this one. So this is how we change an assertive sentence into interrogative sentence when an auxiliary verb is given in the sentence. Okay, so this is one way of changing. Another way is when no auxiliary verb is given. When no auxiliary verb is given, that means a hidden verb is there, that is a do verb is there. So how do we do that? We change it by using do, does, did, or don't, doesn't, didn't. Same thing which applied in the, rule one. That is, if the assertive sentence is an affirmative, then we change it into negative interrogative. And if the sentence is negative, then we change it into positive or affirmative interrogative. All right. So do, does, did, these are used for positive interrogative, and don't, doesn't, didn't is used for negative interrogative. Let us look at the examples. He plays football. There's no helping verb. Okay. Can you see any helping verb over here? No, obviously. So what verb would be used? Does. Why does? Because does is the do verb which is used for simple, which is used for singular present. Okay. When the sentence is in present tense and the subject is what? Singular. Then we use does. Right. And when the sentence is, when the subject is plural and the sentence is present, then we use do. Okay. And when the sentence is in past, then we use what? We use did. Okay. So this is the thing, just keep in your mind that where do we use does, where do we use do, and where do we use did. So here, as you see, the subject is singular and plays is written over here. That means the verb is in present tense. Right. So what do verb would we choose? We'll choose does. So does he play football? There's a mistake over here. The answer will be doesn't he play football. Why? Because the sentence is what? Affirmative. Okay. It is affirmative. So for affirmative, what do we use? We use a negative interrogative. So here it will be doesn't. Okay. N and T. Doesn't he play football? Next, they did not play football yesterday. So this is a negative sentence. So what will we be writing? We'll be writing, did they play football yesterday? We'll be making it into a positive interrogative, bare interrogative. Okay. So I hope this is clear. When the auxiliary verb is given, then we take out the auxiliary verb, place it in the beginning, and we do the transformation in the interrogative and in the negative and affirmative as required. And the second rule says when the auxiliary verb is not given, then we use the do verb and do the same thing with the affirmative and negative part. Rule 3 says if there is never used in a sentence, right? Never is there in the sentence, then what do we do? to make it interrogative, to do a verb will be used. To do verb will be used. That means do, does, didn't. And never is replaced by ever. Okay, this is the main thing. Never is replaced by ever. Let us see how it is done. I never drink tea. No auxiliary verb. That means we will be using do verb. Okay, with I, we use do. When I is in present tense, then we use do. So, I never drink coffee. I never drink tea. Do I ever drink tea? So, this will be the answer. Right? Never is changed into ever. And also, don't forget to place a question mark towards the end because we are transforming it into interrogative. Rule number 4. Everybody, everyone, and all. When the sentence, assertive sentence, has these words, everybody, everyone, all. Okay, so they are replaced by who? Who don't, who doesn't, or who didn't. So when suppose all is used, so that means plural. So we'll be using who don't, right? When everybody or everyone is given and the sentence is present, then who doesn't? And when everybody, everyone, and all are given in past tense, then who didn't? All right. So let us look at the examples. Everybody wishes to be happy, right? Everybody wishes. Now everybody is a singular number. Then wishes is there. That means it is a present tense. So what will we be using? Who doesn't, right? So who doesn't wish to be happy? Now when we are using does, we remove es from the main verb, right? So who doesn't wish to be happy? Who doesn't wishes to be happy would be a wrong statement. Who doesn't wish to be happy will be the correct one. Everybody hates a liar. Okay, so who doesn't hate a liar? Where has a liar one? Okay, so assume that there is a liar written over here. So who doesn't hate a liar and then question mark. Now, next rule number 5 says, if there is nothing used in a sentence, that means if the word nothing is used in a sentence, then to make it interrogative, we start the sentence with an auxiliary verb as we used to do, and nothing is replaced by anything. Okay, never is replaced by ever, and nothing is replaced by anything. Okay, so all these words you have to just memorize. I would say that which word changes to which. See, there was nothing to do. Now here, what do we have? We have an auxiliary verb. So if you recall the first rule, where auxiliary verb is given in the sentence, we pick out the auxiliary verb, we place it in the beginning. And rule number 5 says, when there is a word nothing given in the sentence, it is replaced by what? Anything. So the sentence will go like this. Was there anything to do? Okay, when we pick out the auxiliary verb and place it in the beginning, then we do not use it for the second time in the sentence. So was there anything to do will be a wrong statement. The answer will be, was there anything to do? We have picked out the auxiliary verb. We have placed it in the beginning. Then we used there. Then we won't be using was because we have already used. Okay. So let us strike it out. Then nothing is changed into anything. And to do is written as to do. Okay. Simple. It has been changed. It has been transformed. Right. So that was all about the change, the transformation of an assertive sentence into interrogative sentence. When you are given to change an assertive sentence into interrogative sentence, rules are there for you. And when you are asked to change an interrogative sentence into an assertive sentence, the same rules will be applied. Okay. So there is nothing exclusive which you have to learn about the vice versa. Now, exclamatory to assertive and vice versa, okay? When you are asked to convert an exclamatory sentence into assertive sentence, these are the rules. And when you are asked to transform an assertive sentence into exclamatory sentence, again, the rules are the same. So let us look what it is. In assertive sentence, when the question is an exclamatory sentence and you see what it is beginning with, what, then what is replaced by very or really. Okay, what a beautiful scene is this. This is a really beautiful scene, or this is a very beautiful scene. So very and really both go with this. So let us look at the examples. What a nice child you are. Okay, so the sentence is an exclamatory sentence and it is beginning with what. So what do we do? You are a, then in place of what, we write very nice child. Okay, this you can do. This is very simple. Just you have to remove what and you have to add very in place of it. Okay, and of course the rearrangement you have to see. This you already know. So we won't be going into the rearrangement thing. So you are a very nice child. Now, if in an assertive sentence, how is given, if in the exclamatory sentence, how is given, then how is again replaced by very. For instance, how beautiful you sing. You sing very beautifully. How beautifully you sing? You sing very beautifully. In place of how, we are writing very, and we are ending the sentence with a full stop because now it is a declarative sentence. Okay. And similarly, if the question would have been given this way, you sing very beautifully, and you were asked to change it into exclamatory, then we would have done this. In place of very, we would have started with how. Okay. See, because this is an action, so how will be used? What beautifully you sing would be the wrong statement. Okay. What is for another thing and how is for another thing. Now, when in the exclamatory sentence, hurrah is there, then it is replaced by it is a matter of joy. Let us see. Hurrah, we have won. It is a matter of joy that we have won. Simple. Again, alas is used to express sorrow. So it is a matter of sorrow, or I am sorry, you can use. Alas, I am undone. It is a matter of sorrow that I am undone. Okay. Or I am sorry, I am undone. This also you can say. Now, if in the exclamatory sentence, if were is used, okay, then what do we use? Subject plus wish plus were, or the past form of verb, is used to change an exclamatory sentence into an assertive sentence. See, look at the example. If I sang a song, this shows a wish. Such type of statements show a wish. So what do? In place of if, we write I wish. I wish I sang a song. Okay. So you just have to simply remove if and insert these two words. I wish. Okay. Now when you have were had, okay, this again shows a wish only. So look at the example. Were I a child again? So I am wishing that if I were a child again. So again, in place of not in place of were, you have to add I wish, because you will be using were after this I. So I wish I were a child again. I wish I were a child again. This is the thing. Now, if in the exclamatory sentence, if or would is given, okay, again, this shows the wish only. So we will be using the word wish in the assertive sentence. So let us look at the example. Would that we could play cricket. Okay, so we wish we could play cricket. Who all are talking? You have to pay attention to the verb, to the pronoun also. Okay, here you won't be using I wish, because the pronoun we has been used over here. So you have to use we wish. Okay, so let us look at the previous slides to know what all are the words which are used for wish. If were or if I, okay, is used, then also it is it shows wish. There also you have to write down wish. Look, you have to observe the pronoun also before changing it into assertive. If I is used, that means I wish. If we is used, that means we wish. Okay. Then were I a child again, were also shows wish only, and would also shows wish only. So this is the structure of transformation of sentences from exclamatory to assertive, right? So this is it. These are all the rules now, and we have come to the end of the chapter. We have done all the kinds of transformation. So if you have any question, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Otherwise, we'll start with the practice. You people are very smart. So let us start with the practice. Okay. So here comes the question set. Which says, transform the following sentences into assertive and interrogative as required. Okay, this sentence is a mixture of assertive also and interrogative also. So you have to see which sentence is of what kind, and then you have to transform it into the respective, type of sentence. So just take a moment, look at all the 5 questions and try the answers. Let me see who will answer the first one. Yes, Shubh. So she is tall. What will be the answer, Shubh?
Isn't she tall?
Very good. This is an affirmative sentence. So we'll be transforming it into negative interrogative. Isn't she tall? Right? Next. They watch movie on every weekend. Divyanshi.
Don't they watch movie on every weekend?
Very good. Don't they watch movie on every weekend? She has used a do verb. Why? Because there is no auxiliary verb. Excellent. Third, everyone wants to be successful in life. Let me see who will answer this. Khushi.
Who doesn't want to be successful in life?
Wants or want?
Ma'am wants.
Why? I told you when you are using a do verb, then we use the first form of verb only, okay? Without any S. And if the verb is in second form, then also we write the main form of verb. So who doesn't want to be successful in life? Right, Khushi? Very good.
Yes, ma'am.
Is there anything which can cure this disease? Now, this is an interrogative sentence and you have to change it into an affirmative sentence, an assertive sentence. Yes, Umeed? Is there anything which can cure this disease? Anything is replaced with?
Ma'am, is there nothing which can cure this disease?
You have used the correct word for replacement, but the structuring is wrong. You have to change it into assertive. Rearrange it a little bit. How will you say it in a statement? This is a question, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So what will you do? Okay, let me ask someone else.
Ma'am, is there nothing which could...
A statement doesn't start with an auxiliary verb. Okay, a question starts with an auxiliary verb. Let me see who can answer. Arav?
Yes, ma'am. And there is nothing which can cure this disease.
Absolutely correct. There is nothing which can cure this disease because we have to change it into assertive. Okay. And when we are changing an interrogative sentence into assertive sentence, we place the auxiliary verb in its place, in its own place. Okay. We just do the reverse of what we were doing when we were changing an assertive sentence into an interrogative sentence. Correct. He never speaks truth. Who will tell me the answer for this? Okay, Shubh. Yes, Shubh.
Does he ever speaks truth?
Does he ever speaks or speak?
Speak.
Does he ever speak truth? Okay, two rules have been applied over here. Very good, Shubh. One is there is no auxiliary verb, so he has very correctly used a do verb. And second, never is being used over here, so he has replaced this word never with ever. Very good. Now, let us move on to the next set of questions. Here, you have to transform the following sentences into assertive and exclamatory as required. Okay, so just look at the sentence and do the transformation quickly. Right. The rose smells very sweetly. Yes.
How sweetly the rose smells.
Very good. How sweetly the rose smells, and then an exclamation mark. Correct. Very good. See, you tried and you got the answer correct. Next, what a beautiful painting it is, Priyanshi.
Ma'am, this is a very beautiful painting.
Absolutely correct. Very good. This is a very beautiful painting. Next, it is a matter of joy that we have done it. It is a matter of joy that we have done it. Who will answer? Umid. Yes, Umid.
Ma'am, hooray, we have won it.
We have done it.
Okay. Ma'am, hooray, we have done it.
Very good, very good. Next, if I were a bird. Shubh.
I wish I were a bird.
Very good. Last one will be answered by Arab has answered twice. So now was not answered. Khushi. Yes, Khushi, you gave an incorrect answer.
I wish I could visit Taj Mahal this year.
Very good. I wish I could visit Taj Mahal this year. Absolutely correct. So I assume that you people have understood it quite well because today you people were very good in answering. Your answers were correct. So thank you, children.